All right, so if everyone looks at the screen right here, and after everything, we'll have plenty of chances to ask questions after the whole demonstration. So if everyone looks at the screen right here where you see enter PIN number, this is how all the users, managers, owners, raiders, bartenders will get into their system. Each will have a unique PIN number, and they'll get in here. Now, just to show you briefly here, here is the demonstration menu we have set up here. Now, if you look, everything on the left in the black buttons and white print are screen categories. When you highlight one, like for example, hot salads, the blue buttons with white print are the items that go in that. I just want to show you that so you see what we're doing here. And the first thing I'll do is just show you how easy it is to make a transaction here. Then we're going to go into a lot of other different things. So the first thing I'm going to do, we're just going to order some toast. And we're going to just order some oatmeal. Now, the first thing I'm going to do is just show you how to actually make just a normal, easy transaction here. So if everyone looks here, the amount due is $4.24. We're going to go underneath that and hit pay. Now, once you do that, it's going to bring you up to this second window. Now, if you look on the left pane of this second window where you see the 1 3/4, 2/3, 1/2, this is what you do if a customer wants to pay, let's say he wants to pay his check partially in cash or partially in credit, and that's how you would do that. Now, unfortunately, I can't really show you a credit transaction. I don't have credit card processing up on here, but just to demonstrate you, when you do credit, you click on the credit button. It's going to bring them there. Now, you will have a credit card swiper on the side of your POS, and you will swipe that at that time, and that's all you really have to do that. But I can show you a cash transaction, so let's look over here. So right now the bill is $4.24. To the right pane here, 1, 5, 10, 20, these are your shortcut keys for cash. If it's anything and other than this, you would just put these in with the blue buttons. So we're going to say the customer gave you $5 in cash. And if you see here, there's change. At that point, your cash drawer will open. You're going to say, oh, done. Receipt a printout, and that is all you have to do to make a transaction. Now, for everyone in the audience who's wondering here, what about splitting checks and so forth, let me show you that right now because that comes up a lot. So what first thing I'm going to do is just go in here. We're going to order just two things just to show you. Now, if everyone notices here, to the left of the pancake, there's an icon of a person. So that signifies one person, and it's always in the best interest, even if the tables are not split, to always put how many people are there. So I'm going to add another person, and to do that, if you look on the bottom here, kind of below amount due, you're going to hit that new person button. So we're going to put three people at this table, and then for the second person, we're going to just order them a couple things, and the third person, we're going to order. All right, so here's the scenario. We got three people sitting at a table. The waiter or waitress comes over and says, okay, your bill is $21.62, and they're going to tell you at that point, ah, we want to split it, you know, all three of us. It's very simple to do in this system. If you notice, all the icons of the people there are blue. So what we're going to do is highlight each one, and that would involve this. I'm using my mouse. If you decide to go with Harbortouch Hospitality, you would just use the touch screen and just click on these icons. So right now we click on all of them. So what we're going to do is underneath new person, we're going to go down here and hit split ticket. Now, if you notice, the first option on the split ticket is actually opposite of splitting a ticket. It puts everyone to one ticket. So we're going to go to the second one here that says split selected people to new tickets. So we're going to hit split. We're going to hit OK. And we're going to hit OK one more time. And if everyone notices here, now there is three tickets here. So very simple to do that. And I know a lot of places have split tickets. And, you know, a lot of places have problems with that sometimes. It gets crazy. So now, before I even get into anything else, I just want to explain how the process works here at Harbortouch. Let's say one of you who's listening to this webinar decides to go with Harbortouch. The process is you would talk to one of our order administrators, and at that point, you would give them their menu. Now, they will talk to you about your menu to make sure you know that we're all on the same page, how you want it programmed in, and all your options and so forth. When you do that, then it will come to either me or one of my co-workers, because I'm in the programming department, and we'll program your menu as fast and as efficiently as we possibly can. Once we are done with that, we're going to hand it over to our quality department. Quality department checks it, makes sure everything looks right, makes sure everything looks accurate, makes sense. And when they're done with that, they hand it to our deployment team. Now, what the deployment team is going to do is take all the hardware that you're purchasing out of the box, and they're going to set it all up in here in-house, and they're going to test it, make sure everything's functioning, make sure everything's working properly. When they're satisfied with that test, they're going to package your whole all your hardware up, and they're going to ship it out to you. Now, depending on where you are in the country, but most of the time, the day after they ship it out to you, they're going to give you a call, and they're going to ask you when is this, you know, they're going to tell you when is a good time for our guys to come and install our system. Once you work out that date, our guys will come over there and install your POS system. Now, once it is up and running, that is when you're entitled to our training services. Training services work over the phone and through the internet, kind of similar to what we're doing here, and you could have as many as you want. They're unlimited. They're usually 2 hours a session, but you could have as many as you want. And what it does is you'll be on the phone with one of our trainers, and they'll be connected to your POS system, and you'll say, how do I do this, or can you show me how to do that? And that's how it is. So then you'll be able to, you know, once you get a couple trainings, and you'll be able to do all this stuff yourself. So I just wanted to explain how the whole system works there, how our whole process works there, and that's how we go there. So now, first thing I want to do is go into, if everyone looks above beverages and egg, there is a manager button in there. And in this manager button is pretty much how you do everything with the system. It's how you add new items. It's how you change prices and so forth. And I'll go over them for you. So what we're going to do in here first is we're going to go to the first button in here that says menu. Now in here you'll see there's your screen categories, and that's what you saw on that first page. Just to go back here, here's your beverages, breakfast, appetizers. And we're going to go back here. And next, underneath that is your item groups. Now, when you create a screen category, and to create a screen category is very, very simple, you would click on that button, you would go down here and hit New, and you write whatever screen category you want as the name. Now, 99% of the time when you create a new screen category, you're going to create an item group with the same name. And what that does is does two things for you. It helps you with reporting. And it also helps you in navigation and easy navigation through your menu items, which I will demonstrate in one bit. And to add an item group is pretty much the same exact as screen categories. You would click, highlight it, hit it once, go down to new, and whatever, write the item group with name that you would like in there. All right, so next thing we're going to do is going to go down to menu items. Now, a menu item is any single button on your machine that you're selling any product or service or anything. So if you decide to go with Harbortouch Hospitality, when you get your system, you'll be able to go in here, and if everyone notices here, it says sort by name. You'll be able to see every single item that your restaurant or bar has in alphabetically. It'll have every single item in here. Now, let's say you're going to go down here, sort by. We're going to go to item group, and here's where your item groups come to play. You'll see, oh, here's all my appetizers. Here's all my beverages. Here's all the bottled beer. So that's how the item groups come into play. Now, one of the first questions a lot of people ask me is, once you get the system, and depending on, you know, you might have to change some prices around, change some items around. It's very, very simple to do with this system, and I will show you that right now. So let's say we just got our system, but we need to change some prices around. It's costing us more to buy certain things. And we're going to just say, for example, we're going to go for this Bushmills whiskey. We're going to go for the Irish whiskey. So we're going to highlight that. And we're going to go down here and hit edit. Now, if everyone could see here, right now we're currently charging $5 for this Bushmills whiskey, and we're going to switch that up. So switch it up, it's very simple. You would just go in there, highlight it, and we're going to say we want $9 for it. And when you're done with that, you're just going to go down here and hit OK. And that's all you have to do to change prices. You could change prices how often and how needed you want. There's really no limit on it. You can limit other employees from doing that if you don't want them to do that, but yeah, you could do that as, you know, to your heart's content, basically. So now the other thing is, you know, let's say you went for Harbortouch Hospitality, you got your system, and of course you're going to want to add new items. Very, very simple to do, and I'm going to show you that right now. So this time we're going to click menu items, and instead of going down here and hit edit, we're going to go over here and hit new. And this is going to bring up this blank window here. Now I'm going to show you how to go through this. Now I'm doing it in the order I always do, but it doesn't really mean that's the order you have to do it, just to show you. So first thing, when you create a new item, you're going to want to go in here and create your revenue class. Now, we have pre-built revenue classes for you, food, beer, wine, liquor, beverages, retail, gift cards. And you can also create new revenue classes for you. And I'll go over revenue classes once we go through this too as well. So that we're going to create a food, and then we're going to go to item group. We're going to pick sandwiches. And then we're going to go to screen category, and we're going to pick sandwiches too, if I could find them. There they are. So next we're going to go and name the item. So we're going to say this is a peanut butter sandwich. All right, now one more thing you want to do is click this. We're going to click this. Item has a unique price, and we're going to say we're going to charge $6.75 for this. Now, the difference between making a new item and creating a new item and editing an existing item is almost explained on these green buttons. When you edit something and change it, you hit OK. The other green button, if everyone looks at it, it says right here, save as new item. So we're going to click that. And we're going to just go back here just to show you where it's at. We're going to look in our sandwiches category, and there's our peanut butter sandwich there. So that's how you create that. It's very easy. Once you play around with it and use it enough, you'll see it's very simple to do. So we're going to go back in the manager. We're going to go back in the menu. And now underneath the menu item is the choice sets. Now what choice sets are is what we call our modifiers or options. And just the two most famous choice sets we always have, you know, there's the meat temperature or the salad dressing. So we're going to just create a choice set just for the item I created. So we're going to go in here and go to choice set. Now creating a choice set in that is kind of a three process deal. First, and I'm going to show you, we're going to first go in here and do the choice set. We're going to hit new. And we're going to name this choice set bread. All right, now there's a lot of different options you can have for choice sets. You could set the rules. Do we want one choice or multiple choice? Now, of course, for a meat temperature, you'd only want one choice. But maybe for sides, and next for sides, you're going to be able to do that. So now you can also have it optional persistent, which I usually have on all my choice sets, or required. Now required makes it that the server waitress cannot move forward. Let's say you have a required choice set on the meat temperature. They will not be able to move forward with that ticket unless you fulfill that requirement and basically picking a meat temperature. Then on the bottom here is prepend choice set, which I normally usually do. And what that does is it shows this bread and the colon on the ticket so you know exactly what you're getting there. So we're going to hit OK. And I already have a bread one there, so we're going to just change this up a little bit. We're going to say bread type. And we're going to hit OK. So we created a choice set name. Next step is right underneath there. We're going to go in here and create choices. And we're going to hit new. Now, once you create choices, you're going to go into choice sets. And we're going to pick that one I just said, bread type. And we're going to say, how about pumpernickel? And we're going to just say wheat. We'll just give it 2. And wheat's already used, so we'll say rye. And that's already used. See, what happens is when choice sets are always already used, you would just go to the choice of this actual item, and we could just throw this over. Now, there's a lot of different options with choice sets. You could put prices on them. You could put prices on the choices. So, you know, depending where you're at, a bar or diner or a restaurant, you know, we could accommodate all the needs for that as well. So we're just going to pick these two choices. Now, if you notice, there's two choices, and there's one more step we have to do. It's to the left of that cancel button, and it's items with this choice set. We're going to click on that, and we're going to find our peanut butter and jelly sandwich. We're going to click that over there. Now, if you notice here, the left pane does not have the bread type choice set. The right pane does. And we just added it over there. If we want to add anything over there, you just click it and put it over there. Very simple. If you decide you don't want it there, just move it back. So we're going to hit OK. We're going to hit OK. And I just want to show you, everyone, that. We're going to go to peanut butter sandwich. There's your bread type. Pick pumpernickel. So that's how the choice sets work. All right, so next thing we're going to go back in the manager, back in the menu, and underneath that is revenue classes. Now, I said we have pre-built revenue classes. Basically, our revenue classes are really we use them for reporting purposes, but also for tax purposes. A lot of places throughout the country, I discovered now, you know, some places charge certain tax for food, certain tax for liquor, certain tax if it's eaten inside, certain tax if it's out to go. So these revenue classes kind of help you with that. And like I said, you could also create revenue classes, you know, in order to, you know, fulfill whatever kind of taxes you have in your particular area of the country. Now, underneath revenue classes is our taxes. And if you decide to go with Harbortouch Hospitality, you would send us our tax rate. Now, we could accommodate a lot of different sales taxes. If you notice on this particular menu is all the food. We're going to go here, all the food and beverages have a tax on it. and all of the liquor and beer have a hidden tax, included tax. So we'll be able to accommodate a lot of different things with the taxes. Just let us know what it is, basically. So, all right, so we got through all that. We're going to go out of here now. And one of the first things I tell merchants when they get our POS software is to one of the first things they want to do when they get the software is go underneath the button menu and hit their employee button. And you're going to go in here and hit new, and you're going to want to put your name here. Now, if everyone could see, there's a lot of different information you could put in here. But the only real thing that is required is your screen name and PIN number. You could put all this other different information you want. Put your PIN number, that's going to get in your system. Your screen name is going to show you. Now, the real important thing of this, if everyone looks to the right here, is the security settings. Now, the security settings are basically the rights that you give yourself. Now, normally when I'm talking to people in regards to this POS, I'm talking to either the manager, the boss, or someone, you know, who went into that, and which I always let them know is, you know, if for yourself, I would give every single right that you want. Give yourself everything. If it's checked, if you could do it, it's unchecked, you can't do it. Maybe for the employee you hired 2 days ago, maybe you don't want them to do discounts, or maybe you don't want them to be able to change prices. So what this system is, it could basically have your employees do what you want them to do and really nothing more. Now, over time, let's say that one employee, you know, been there for a while, so forth, you could come in there, edit their rights, but you know what, now, you know, I trust you, you could do this and that now. So it's very nice how you could set up what your employees can do, and so, you know, it keeps things on the up and up. All right, so we're going to go out of that. Now, underneath employees is jobs. So you could go in here and create a new job. Now, if everyone notices here, I have a couple jobs in here already. We're just going to go in here and edit the cook here. You could put their pay rate in there, their overtime pay rate, a lot of different, different options as well here. If this job declares tips at clock out or so forth like that. So you can put your job in and put your pay rate in. What's really nice is we're going to go over here to labor. And what this does is it does all your hours for you. It finds your hours. So you as a manager can come here, say show shifts in the last couple of weeks, month, or customize them. I'm just going to show you 5 days. And you can see all the hours of your employees. Now, let's say one of your employees forgot to clock out, or let's say one of your employees accidentally put in more hours than he actually worked. You as a manager could come in here, edit it, and make sure the shifts that they're working are accurate, that they're the right shifts. Now, speaking of all the hourly in that, I want to show you how an employee will actually do that. Now, let's assume I'm an employee. I just came to work. The first thing I'm going to do is go in here and put my PIN number in. Right, gets me into this system. Now there's going to be a second step if you're going to be on the clock. And if everyone looks right above that coffee hidden, it looks like an envelope. It's called your personal page. So you can come in here and choose your starting shift. Now I only have one shift in the past 24 hours, so I can't select that. That's because I'm a demo user. But this is how you would clock in for the day. Now, of course, when you go on break, you would clock out. And when you're done for the day, you're going to go in here and hit clock out. And it wouldn't let me clock out because I have a ticket open. Let me just knock that out real quick. And we're going to go in here and clock out. And now, see, my demo user is logged in as a manager. If I was not, let's say I was a bartender, that there'll be a spot right here to declare tips. So our employees can put your tips in there and know what's going on. All right, so... Now, so that's it. And this right here would be a report for what that particular user, what they sold that day. Now, this option, some employees I dealt with already do not want their, some managers don't want their employees to be able to see that. Some do. So this can be removed if you don't not want them to see that. You know, it's just another thing to think about there. All right, so we're going to go back into our manager. And next thing we're going to cover is I'm going to go over this icon right here. This is what you call the fresh sheet. Now, what Fresh Sheet is basically kind of an inventory service that we have on here, and I'm just going to demonstrate it with you with these this absolute vodka. So when you want to use the Fresh Sheet, you put whatever item over to this right pane here, and then we're going to edit it. So we're going to say I think there's about 25 shots in a bottle of vodka. So we're going to hit that, and we're going to hit OK. Now what this does for you is, and I'm just gonna go back one more. Now if everyone sees on this where you enter your PIN number, it already says Absolut Vodka 25. So we're gonna actually make a purchase of that, and I also wanna show you the button. So we're gonna go down to Vodka, and we're gonna order. Now it also has that, if everyone notices there, on the Absolut Vodka, it has the 25 right in the corner there. So we're gonna just click on that. We're gonna buy one of these. And we purchase one, and if everyone notices there, we look at the Absolut Vodka, it's down to 24. So that's basically what it, I mean, it's kind of a basic inventory system. It works pretty well depending on what you're doing. You could use it, you don't have to just use this on liquor, you can use this on food, different drinks, and you know, whatever you really want to use it on. So that is the fresh sheet. So all right, we're gonna go back into manager. And next thing I want to show you is we're gonna go down here and we're gonna go to the reports. This system is very full of a lot of different reports. If everyone can see, these are all just the sales reports itself. We have different categories of reports. We have product mix, auditing, menu, transactions, customers, labor for export. You could also go in here in a flex report and customize and create your own reports if you would like to as well. So I'm just going to demonstrate one report here. So how you would do a report is you're just going to go hourly sale performance. You're going to just highlight whatever one you were thinking about it. So we're going to just go hourly sales performance. Now once you do that, you go over here to the right and you have to fill in this criteria. Do we want it from last year, from last quarter, from last month, last week? Do we want it from yesterday, a couple minutes ago, a couple hours ago? Or you could even click on this date range and then pick your start and end. Do we want the whole year of 2011 or do we want the whole month of June? So it's all up to you. So I'm just going to go right here. I'm just going to leave it as today, and we're going to hit show report. And you'll have to excuse my computer. It has a lot of things running on there, so it's not. There we go. So if everyone could see here, we sold a total of $8.72 today. And now what's real nice about these reports is you could print this report out, of course, keep a hard copy, but you could also save this as a PDF file, an RTF, an Excel file, a CSV file, and then if need be, maybe take it home to your home computer, your office computer, or maybe to your accountant. So you'll be able to take these reports and, you know, put them, take them wherever you need to really go. All right, so we're going to go out of here. We're going to get out of reports. And next thing I'm going to show you is this kind of a nice little tool in here that we have. This is what we would call our messaging system. So let's say this scenario. A manager at his restaurant comes in early, performs on employees, but he realizes he has to go, so he wants to tell them a message before they go, and they have not even checked in yet. So what we would do is go into this messaging button, go down here and hit new. And right here we're going to hit message 2. Now what's nice about this is this will have every single employee you put in your system. You could also send this message to every single employee, or maybe to one employee, or to two or three. So you could send it to whoever particular you want to do it. So we're just going to send this to myself. I'm going to hit OK, and I'm going to say, please clean up the kitchen. So we're going to send that message out there. Now let's say that, you know, that manager left for the day. He had to take care of some things, but he wanted to make sure that they cleaned up that kitchen. So his other employee who sent that to comes in. Now if everyone looks above the coffee, there is the personal page right there. So he's gonna have to go in there to clock in, or he's not going to get paid. So he's going to see that message, say, please clean up the kitchen. All right, the boss wants me to clean that, and delete it. So the messaging system is a very nice, handy tool. Keeps communication going with all your employees. You know, there's no real way they could say, oh, I didn't see that message. If they did, they didn't clock in and didn't get paid for the day. So it's a nice, handy tool. All right, so we're going to go back into manager. And next thing I'm going to show you is we're going to go over here into sections. Now this system, a lot of places when they decide to go with Harbortouch Hospitality, they send us a picture of their layout. And just to show you, we're going to go in here. Here's the patio. Here's the bar stools. Here's the fireplace, dining room. And what's real nice about that, let me just demonstrate how the sections loose. So we're just going to order a couple things. Now if everyone looks on the top, above the icon there, it looks like a blue table. We're going to click on that, and we're going to say these people are sitting at the fireplace dining room. So we're going to go in there, and we're going to pick the seat. And what's real nice is we're going to pick how many people sit at the table. You can pick 1 through 6 right there. If it's higher than 6, you just this button and put a how many people are in there. So we're just going to say 4 people are there. All right, so we're going to hit OK. And if you notice, when we pick the 4 people, if you notice, we pick 4 people, and automatically it puts the 4 icons on there. It automatically puts the icons on there right away, so we have 4 people out there. So that's it. And what's also nice is, let's say they didn't pay the ticket. That you could see right here, okay, this ticket's from Fireplace Dining Room Table 6, and there's 4 people on there. So that's kind of a nice tool for the sections. And like I said, you send us your section. We put it in there the best we got. We got multiple sections. Sometimes we do, you know, second floor, first floor, bar, patio. So we could do a lot of different things in there for you. So I'm just going to delete this ticket out. And we're going to go back into manager. Now, next under sections, we're going to go into discounts. Discounts are very, very nice in this system. And I'm just going to show you how we're going to create a discount or two. So we're going to go down here and hit new. And we're going to, first thing you want to do is name the discount. So I'm just going to name this family discount. Now, there's 3 different ways to discount here. We could do a forced price. So let's say an item costs $10.99. We could force that to $7.99. Or we could do a dollar amount off, you know, $2 or $3 off. Or we could do a percentage off. We could also do this discount on this items itself or on the whole ticket. So we're going to say this family discount, we're going to put it on the whole ticket. And we're going to say we'll give our family 50% off. Now, what you do then, once you do all that, you could either go specific items to say what this applies for, or you could go to item groups to say, okay, we only want this on appetizers, breakfast, desserts, entrees. So I'm just going to show you how we're going to run this discount. So we're going to hit okay. We're going to go back, and we're going to order an appetizer. We're going to order cheese. Order a couple things there. Now, let me just show you this. And please, everybody, after I'm going through with all that, we'll have a nice question and answer session. So if you please could just hold your questions till the end there. I just want to go over this stuff, then I'll be definitely willing to answer all your questions. So if you just could hold on for a little bit there. All right, so what we got here is some items here. It's 21. Now, if we want to discount a ticket, we're going to go to the bottom there, kind of right below that one of one, we're going to hit discount ticket. Now, when you click discount ticket, every discount you created that applies to the whole ticket will show here. If you notice here, we have 4 right here. Here's my family discount that I created, so I'm going to click on that, and it took my 50% off there. So that's how we're going to do that. So let me just void that ticket. Now, I'm going to go back into discounts. Now, we're going to go back into new. Now, for all the people in the audience who have bars or even restaurants, basically who have a happy hour or who have some kind of deal like at a certain time, this system works excellent for that. So I'm just going to demonstrate. We're going to go in here and say happy hour. And we're going to say we want to take $1.50 off. And we're going to do it only on these 3 Absolut Vodkas. Now, what's real nice is right now it's $1.50 off all these. What's real nice is we're going to hit this button right here that says apply this discount automatically. And we're going to go down. We're going to say happy hour starts at 5 p.m. And let's say it ends at 8 p.m. So now, currently, and if you could do days available, I'm going to say every day of the week. So now, if I hit OK here, this system automatically will discount every Absolut Vodka $1.50 between 5 and 8. When 8:01 comes, it will come back to the normal price like it normally is. So there's less room for error for your servers, less room for, you know, less money being charged. And, you know, it works out. Now, I have done a lot of bar menus with hospitality here, and there's some places I did, you know, maybe 10 happy hours, one for liquor, one for beer, one for wine, one for mixed drink, call drink. So it works very well, and it really, what it does is it doesn't, your bartender and so forth don't have to worry about what the prices is. It's already discounted automatically depending on that time. Like I said, if they order something at $7.59, it'll still be $1.50 off. If they order it at 8:01, it'll be back to the same price. So the discounts in here work very, very good. All right, let's go back here. So we went through that. Now, underneath discounts is the void button. Now, we have a couple default voids in there, testing, spill, walkout, mistake, return. And basically what this is, you could go in here and just put in a void reason. I'm just going to say error. And you can put in the different reasons. You can also do a port to see which employees are voiding a lot or not to make sure, you know, everything's on the up and up. But this is to show you how to void it. And I'm sure all you saw me do it a couple times already just to show you. We're going to hit shrimp cocktail. Then the customer's going to tell me, no, I want something else. At this point, I would go down here and hit void ticket. And we're going to say error. And that's pretty much how you do to void. So we're going to go back into manager. And a couple of other things I want to show you. Actually, we're going to go to the front screen here. And I'm going to go over here. See if everyone sees that vegetarian pizza, right above that, I want to go in there and hit customer. Now, this system carries a customer. You can have a customer database in here. What's real nice about it is, let's say this person right here. Let's say you have the customer that comes in your place every 3 days, orders the same thing. You could go down here and say, oh, you want your favorite? Oh, here it is. And your favorites will be there. If they want something different, you just go in here and hit new ticket. Their name will be on there already. And that's how the customer database works. Now, what else? I'm going to go in here and just to add a new customer. And now, the only thing required in the customer database, as you see, is the first name. So I'm going to put my name in there and put me in there. Now, what's nice also about this is there's also a caller ID feature that we could have, which will help, which will, especially for places that, you know, that do delivery and stuff, you keep put your information in there, it'll bring up the customer's name and so forth when you do that. Now, speaking of customer databases, there's another thing that coincides with that, and we're going to go into manager, we're going to go down to advanced, and this is what we call our loyalty program. And I'm going to click use loyalty features, and basically what the loyalty feature is it allows you to put points on different products that you're selling. So let's say, back to these absolute vodkas, we're going to say, let's say this one gives us 50 points. So every time a customer orders this absolute citron, you're going to get 50 points. Then you, as the owner of the restaurant or bar, you're going to put a discount in there and say, you know, when you get 300 points, you get a discount for this, or when you get 200 points, you get a free meal. So that's kind of how that works. And just to demonstrate that real quick, I'm going to go in there, and I'm just going to show you how many. I'm going to put my name. We're going to add me to the built-in loyalty ad. Okay, so I'm going to go in here, new ticket. I'm going to order that absolute just to show you to accumulate some points. And I think it was the citron, five. All right, so now we're going to go back into my name, Wyatt Offers. And if you see here, I have 50 points now because I just bought that. So that's how that works. That's how the customer system works. And let's go back in here. And I'm wondering if there's anything. Now, let's see here. All right, the other thing I want to touch in here is actually a couple things I want to. We're going to go into system. Now, what system can do for you? You could apply gratuity automatically. So let's say, you know, there's so many people at a table, you could set up the gratuity for yourself. You could prompt for a table section every time. And we could go back here. So, and then let me show you some other things in here. Now, where's the customers? All right, so we're going to go out of that. Now, the next thing I want to do is underneath system, we're going to go in printers. Now, a lot of places have ordered, when you order a POS system from us, you get a receipt printer with the POS system. A lot of places, people order what we call either the kitchen printer or remote printer. And what that really does for you is, say a customer orders a meal, what that will do is send that ticket to that meal to your cook back in the kitchen, so he'll know exactly how to prepare that. Now, normally when they do that, customers of us will tell us, you know, we want all the food to print to there, or we want this to print to there. And, of course, we'll set that up for you. Now, over time, what I always tell everyone is, when you add new items, you're going to want to do that yourself, but it's very, very simple. So we're going to go in here and edit this kitchen printer. We're going to go to items. Now, if everyone takes notice, items on this left pane here are not printing to the kitchen printer. Items on the right plane are. Well, let's say we added some new items we wanted to print there. It's very, very simple. We're going to just highlight it over. Now it's printing. over. Now it's printing. Oh, we don't want that one there. So now it's not printing. So that's very simple. And that's how that works out there. So let me, at this point in time, let me just open this up for some questions. I will try to get to all your questions. And before I even do that, let me just leave my email here. I'm going to put my email in there just in case there's other questions you might have thought of later in the day. I'm also going to give my boss's email here. His name is Sean. Of course, my name is Wyatt. There's my two emails in there. But feel free to ask as many, feel free to ask some questions. I think we do have some questions out there already. So, okay, let me see here. Can you please discuss reservations and texting customers when table is ready? Kim, I know that is in the works, and I did see a brief demonstration on about that about a month ago, but to be honest, I'm not 100% sure with that. If you could send me an email and just remind me of that, I'll give you all the information I have about that right now. All right, let's see. Please feel free, everyone, to put in some questions in that question box there, and I'll address them one by one. All right, now, I do see that there were some other questions asked. Now, Aaron asked about a coupon for free appetizers. Yeah, you're saying, is that possible, or is that your, I'm not sure what your question is about the coupon. How would you do that? So your question is, you have a coupon that says a coupon for free appetizers. Well, what you could do is you can make a discount that basically says that you could basically say that, hey, that, you know, you can make a discount that says, you know, coupon or one free appetizer, and then you would just run that in there and, you know, take the coupon, run that discount. All right, can you show us? All right. Yeah, I'll show you real quick. So we're going to run a discount, and we're going to say, and what are we going to say? You know, one free app. Let's just say that. Now you could do this, you could force a price, we're going to hit zero, and then we're going to go to item group, we're just going to click on the appetizers. So we're going to go back here, and we're just going to order two. And what this is going to do is, we're going to click in here, we're going to hit discount item, and one free app, and it just knocks the price off of one totally. When setting, let's say, a table for four, can you label each seat whether they are male or female, adult or child? I do not believe so. There might be some way we can finagle that. We talked to our developers in the back. Let me just see here. We're going to go in here, patio. Yeah, no, it doesn't really, you can't really decipher who is what, but that's something we could look into. If inventory is at zero, is the button still there or just not selectable? Yeah, you know what? If the button is still at zero, it'll go into negatives, Jason, to answer that question. All right, David has a question. How do you pre-authorize credit cards, start a bar tab with credit cards? All right, so that's a good question there, David. Just to show you right now, let's say to start a bar tab, regardless of what they're paying, all your, and if everyone notices my happy hour, Kevin, you would just hit OK, and this ticket's still not, you know, it's not paid out. When they want to order more, you would just order another one. So now you're saying about pre-authorization. So let me go into manager. We're going to go into manager system, and we're going to go to credit. I think it's an advanced setup. You would go in here in advanced setup, and you could allow this credit card to be authorized ahead of time. So then that's how you would set that up. Now, like I said, I can't really demonstrate credit card transactions because I don't have that processing set up. But that's how you would do that. And the bar tab, basically what you would do is just leave the ticket open. You could go down here and see all tickets. When you go in there, now you could do it by their table name, do it by, you know, however you want to do it. When they order more, they would just, you know, put another one on there. When they're ready to pay, you would just open it up and pay it out. All right, let's see. Any other questions, concerns, on things might be worried about? Can you make me vary venue? Can you make the menus vary based on time of day, Aaron? Well, you know, actually, that's an interesting question. Let me just touch on that. And we had a lot that does that, breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Now, there's a couple ways to tackle that. But now that you talked about something that I forgot to bring up, actually, David. Aaron, I'm sorry. So let me just show you one thing. In this system, there's no deletion of menu items. So for all the people in the audience there, let's say you have seasonal items, you know, stuff for winter, stuff for summer, there's no deletion. So if everyone takes a look at the screen here, let's say this apricot brandy, let's say we can't get apricots anymore. We're going to go in here and hit deactivate. When you deactivate that, it's no longer in the menu. We're going to hit view all, and we're going to go back to that. And let's say all of a sudden we got apricots back. You would highlight that, and then if you notice, there's the activate. So that's kind of how. Now for lunch, there's a couple ways we could do breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Let's say for lunch and dinner, it's the same exact items, just different prices. Then we'd run some kind of automatic discount to make the prices change. Or a lot of times what we do is we'll say, you know, spaghetti lunch, spaghetti dinner, so something like that. All right, the next question, hopefully that answer. All right, question for Jim. You show table of four. You show seat one, seat two, seat three, and seat four. Can you see where any other labeling is available? I'm not sure what you mean by that, Jim, labeling is available. Yeah. So Aaron, to answer your question is that there's like either we could run a discount. Let's say, you know, if it's cheaper at lunch, we'd run that discount on all them foods if they're exactly the same. Or like I say, we'd have a menu item that says spaghetti colon lunch or spaghetti colon dinner, or we make two items of each. You know, have a different menus for each for lunch. All right, so another question here by Jason is, if two people are working on one terminal and share a cash till, is it easy to toggle between each employee's to ring in items, or should there be a day shift and evening shift of a group of employees? Well, see, the way this system works, Jason, is when this system is idle, and you could set this up, but when it's idle, it's going to go right to here. And that's for security reasons. So you don't want anyone just, you know, walking up and start messing with the POS system. So every time the waiter or waitresses, when they're running around and they come back here, they're going to come back here and log in. So it's really not about problem about, you know, two people using the same cash till, you know, it works good. So our server's going to have to navigate through all of our items for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Yeah, pretty much. I mean, it would make no sense to deactivate breakfast and lunch, you know, at different times. So they run two different checkouts. I'm not sure what you mean. Well, they would take it right at the POS and, you know, pay it right, or however you want, you know, how your system wants to pay, how you would use it. Yeah, you could break them into no way to break them into categories, Aaron. I'm not sure. I'm not sure what you mean by that. Break them into the categories. I mean, we could break them into a lot of different categories if need be. I'm not 100% sure what you meant by that. Yeah, I mean, yeah, you could do it like that, Aaron. I mean, it's pretty much, yeah, exactly. Dinner entrees, you know, lunch salad, dinner salad, you know, yeah, exactly like that. And you can make the categories like that so they know exactly, you know, what it is and where it is. Exactly. Yep. What was the fresh list? You missed that, Aaron. Fresh list is basically, and I'll show you real quick right here. This is basically our inventory. So just to show you, we're going to put over this apricot brandy. And we're going to hit edit, and we're going to see there's 15 in there. And what that does is, now just to show you, yeah, that's basically going to show you how much, see, it's going to show you. It's basically a way to keep inventory. So let's just assume there's 24 shots in that vodka. Once that gets down to low, they're going to have to pull up another bottle of vodka. So that's kind of a way to do inventory. All right, let's see. Any other questions, concerns, anything you might be wondering about, curious about? All right. Bring up the four seats at a table. All right. Does Harbortouch provide any cards for customer loyalty or keep customer records? For example, if I wanted to have a program that records what customer drank so that they have tried all the beers to get a free t-shirt. Well, if you put them in the customer database, you'll be able to find that, you'll be able to track whatever they bought. Now, there is some loyalty cards, which also can be used as employee cards, that you can use for that kind of thing. QuickBooks, well, our system, you can import all of the question Aaron has is something about the QuickBooks. And our system, you can import our files, our reports from here to Excel, different file formats, which then you can import into QuickBooks. So that's kind of how you would do that. All right, they would bring in the card and we would swipe it and bring out records, maybe automatically keep track and alert when all beer tried. Well, David, you'll be able to track, what your customers purchase once you put them in the database. So that's, yes, you'd be able to do that. And we do have some loyalty cards, which also can be used for server cards as well. All right, let's see. Anything else anyone else might be wondering about? Well, no, the question, Aaron, is not importing our sales, importing the report. And when you do a report, like I kind of showed you before, you can import, you can make this into a lot of different file formats. Like here's a report. You could say this is an Excel file. And from an Excel file, it'll probably be easier to put into QuickBooks. And I wouldn't say it's that difficult. And to be honest, I don't mess with QuickBooks that often, but it doesn't see that. All right, bring up a section showing four people at a table. Where would you take orders from each? All right, so let's show this. Let's show you this. We're going to go back here. We're going to go to menu. And we're going to go up menu. Oh, what am I doing here? Sorry about that. All right, so first thing, we're just going to order one thing. We're going to bring up four people. We're going to say patio five, four people. All right. Where would you take orders from each? So you would just highlight that. So if you see that, the first one was the first guy there. So I'm going to go to this one and say he wants this. Then I'm going to highlight him and he wants the soda. Then I'm going to highlight number four and say he wants Rob Roy. So that's kind of how you do it. You would just highlight each one and order who wants what. Can you label type of person at each seat? No, I do not believe so, Jim. I could look into that and see if there is some ways we could get around that, but I do not believe there might be something. And then when you hit OK, you'll see patio five, four people at the table. All right. Let's see. So no notes for the tables, customers. Well, as far as you mean notes. I mean, there's a lot of different, there's always, there's also a special request that you could put into everything that, that special request button, which I didn't go over. I'm just going to go in there, Irish coffee, we have special requests. And you could write, no Irish coffee, but no coffee. So you could write in notes on special requests for every customer. And like I said, special requests you could put down on everything about the food, about the customer. So, yeah, the special requests will work. All right. So let's see. Any other questions, concerns, anything you guys might be wondering about, anything you guys want me to show you? I'm going to be wrapping this up in a little bit. And like I said, you all have my email and my boss's email. Please feel free, if we get off here, feel free to ask us any questions you might have thought of later. You're welcome, Aaron, man. Thanks for listening to me. So is there anything else there? We'll be closing this down in a couple minutes. All right. You're welcome, Dave. And, yes, Kim, there is a house of counts on hospitality. Definitely there is. And let me see here. Bank to the two people on one shift. If one person leaves early and wants to collect tips, then the second person closes out at the end of the shift. Do they run two check-ins? Well, let me just show you one thing here. I'm gonna go to this manager that I am. Maybe this will help you. See, because I'm a manager, I do not declare tips at clockout, but now I am. So let's say you have two people on one POS, one leaves early. They're going to go in there, they're going to hit clockout, and that specific person is going to write in their tips, let's say $45. And that's kind of how that works. So hopefully that kind of showed you that answer right there. All right. Well, hopefully everybody enjoyed this. You guys have a good weekend and take care, and thank you for your time. All right.